Hello YouTube, today at Power Jack Repair .org we got an ASUS N705F N705FD-ES76. The problem is the power connector, that's what the client told me, but I wasn't sure about it. But now that I've taken the cover off, I see that it's the power jack issue. Now usually I show you how to unscrew those screws right here on the bottom, but you just basically unscrew them. And then what you do is you flip this guy over, you put a something like a guitar pick right here, you go all the way around it. What you need to do is you need to flip this guy like that, all the way this way, like that. And you will have all those 1, 2, 3, 4 cables connected to here, 1, 2, 3, 4. What you want to do is you want to flip this hinge this way, that hinge that way, that and that hinge this way. Now, the reason I wasn't sure about the system because I don't have this jack in stock, I think. So let me take this whole thing apart and see. Because the problem I can see right away is with the jack, but the laptop does not respond here. The reason I know it's the jack, because if you look at the rear center pin, you see some blackness on it, right? This is the rear center pin I'm talking about right here. Right here, you see some blackness. So maybe the laptop already dead, but that pin is what caused the issue pretty much right there. And the reason that's bad, because you see this hinge, it moves back and forth here, and it's pretty much messes up with the soldering connection right on the pin. So my guess, if I'm gonna have those connectors in stock, I will have the system here every single day. Not that it's a popular system, it's the first time I see the system. So let's take the battery out. Right. I think somebody already took it apart before because there are screws missing here. Let's take, well, first let's disconnect the battery. Let's take the battery out first. Okay, let's see how we can handle this. Okay, one more screw right here. All right. The reason I want to take the battery out first, because I don't want to short the motherboard in any way, shape, or form. All right, so there is a hingy thingy right here. Another hingy thingy right there. And like that, and like that. And we set this guy aside. Here we want to disconnect this cable right here. Like that. Really dusty fan. And... yes, so something like that. Take this guy out. And take this guy out right here. And like that. Okay. So like that. You know, I didn't turn on my number one light right here. Totally forgot about that. Okay, now it's going to be much brighter picture. All right, so we want to unscrew one right here, one right there, one right here, and one right here. Okay. Good job. Okay. Okay, so that's the dusty fan. Let's clean up the fan first because I don't want... You see the reason why the gloves are so black? It's not because then I'm using a dirty environment. It's all because of the fans being dirty. So let's use this guy right here. Alrighty. Now this is a 70% ISP I'm using on those components. Usually I'm using 99% ISP on motherboards, but for cleaning, nowadays it's 2021, it's really hard to combine by 99% ISP. So I have to use 70. Well, for obvious reasons, I'm not gonna mention why it's hard to come by. Okay, so here like that. Let's clean up this guy. Let's clean up here. And let's clean up right there. Okay. All right. Okay. Alrighty, so what you want to do is you want to disconnect the fan right here, like that, set that aside. Let's raise up the motherboard in a second. You want to put this guy down. There is a little film right here which you want to raise for the monitor to be disconnected, for the LED cable to be disconnected. So once you take this, you see this tape right here? Don't try to pull on the cable without lifting up the cable first. All right, so like that and like that. Good job. All right. Yeah, this jack, I don't know if I have it, but you know what, let me go take a look around and see if I'm gonna find something like that. Alrighty, turns out I do have a few of those jacks in stock. They're not identical. They're basically the same exact thing, right? But this one's gonna be sitting a bit like a couple of millimeters into the board. But it's exactly not... No, it's not exactly the same thing. Well... shoot, I was hoping it's exactly the same thing. Well, anyways, I need to take this guy off, put this guy in and see if it's gonna work. Because looks like exactly the same thing, only it's gonna sit a little bit farther in and a little bit down, which is no big deal, as long as it's gonna work, right? So, here we got a whole bunch of components in the back right there. I usually use Kapton tape, but I just got a new shipment of 3M high temp tape, which wasn't around for quite some time, and I'm just gonna use that because it's a lot, it's closer than the Kapton tape. Well, we can use some Kapton tape to keep this tape down, so something like that. So yeah, Kapton tape. You know what, I want to probably put some Kapton tape on this plastic guy as well, because it's all gonna melt. Let's see, this guy gonna melt first hand. Yep, so it wouldn't melt as much. Here we got a little tiny component right there, which gonna fly off the motherboard for sure. The one right here. I will try to use again this high temp tape, but it's usually useless, quite honestly, because yeah, I mean, there is nothing to... And there is a little component on the top there that might fly off the motherboard as well. Yeah, I mean, no, this is... this guy not gonna hold here. I'm pretty sure about that. So the way to take the connector off the motherboard is to add some flux. Then you wanna add some solder, a leaded base solder. Gonna mix with the unleaded base solder. I wanna insulate the connector here because I don't want it to be damaged from heat. So flux, then you put some leaded base solder mixes with the unleaded base solder, and then you put some hot air and this guy is supposed to pop right out. By the way, you know what, I might be able to put this guy not like that, but upside down. And that way, if it's gonna be upside down, it's gonna align perfectly fine with the casing. Alright, so, yeah, I think I'm probably just gonna put it like that, upside down. Maybe, maybe, maybe not. We will see in a second. And that way it's gonna be on the same level as this guy at. So you can put it like that, or you can put it like that. We will see. Let's switch to the soldering. All right, so I put everything the way I want it to be. All right, so we're putting some flux on the connection. And then I need to raise this guy a little bit so that the jack would have some room where to drop from the motherboard. All right, power up. And now we're gonna add some solder. Okay, now what we have to do is we need to suck all of the solder from the soldering points right here, right there, right here. All right. Oh, shoot. What's going on here? Sorry, the focus was out. I have to solder and I have to look at how the focus is focused. All right. So we remove all of the As you can see, the plastic did melt right here, right here. Well, you can't really do much about that, about melted plastic. Alright, so let me compare the two jacks, see how they're gonna install one compared to another. Yeah, I think if I'm gonna put this one upside down, if it's gonna fit in there, it's gonna fit there just fine. Oh wait, that's not upside down. Is it upside down? That's not upside down. Wait up. How did they remove this guy? Like that, or was it like that? I think it was like that, right? That's the proper way to put it in. So I guess I will just have to flip it like that. Alright. And let's solder it up like that. You know what, I need to check if the casing, to see if the casing gonna allow me for this kind of modification. Alright, so I think, again, this jack probably gonna be for sale from our website. And again, you have to put it upside down like that. That's my assumption. So let's flip this guy over. Let's like that. Put this guy in there like that. And let's solder everything here. I need to put more flux because it doesn't flow as well. Again, the link for the jack will be below. And hopefully, you'll be able to install it upside down just like I did right here. Again, we sell and we ship the jacks all over the world, so it doesn't matter where you're at. We can ship this jack your way, no problem. Or you could send us just the motherboard. We can put this jack like that on the motherboard. Alright, so looks good. Looks good. These two grounds are kind of shorting each other, but it's no big deal. It's all ground anyway. All right, let's clean this guy up a little bit. Shut down the soldering iron. Clean up this stuff. Now, this is 99% ISP because it dries out much faster. Like that. Good job. Everything is nice and clean. Let's clean up this guy right here. Like that, like that. And like that. Excellent. All right, guys, please leave a like if the video was useful. Subscribe, I will let you know which laptops to buy and which ones not to buy. All right, so what we have here? Oh, you see, the jack, the rear of the pin basically has part of the tracer on top of it. The blackness is right there. And that's the reason why it didn't work in the first place. Again, I'm not sure if rest of the motherboard is shorted or not. We will put it all back together and see if it's gonna work. All right. All right. All righty. Okay, let's test to see if there's any shortages on the new connector. Like that. Beautiful. Beautiful. So in theory, everything should work in theory, but you never know how the how's everything turn out to be until you make it all put together. All right, just want to make sure that nobody took apart the laptop heatsink. You see the seal is still there. Is that like that? Okay, so we're gonna park it into the casing like that, and hopefully the hole is gonna align. You know what, I don't want this pad right here because it might be conductive tape, who knows. I don't know. Let's see like that. And how old is this laptop anyway? 22. Oh, was it just made recently? Strange. All right, so let's see if the hole's aligned. Perfectly. Yeah, the hole is perfectly aligned, meaning that you can buy this jack no problem from us. And you can put it upside down and everything should... I'm not sure if the top casing is gonna close down fine or not, but hopefully it will. All right, make sure all of that stuff is nice and tight. Okay. Wait, what's wrong with the picture here? Something isn't right. No, everything seems to be normal, but yeah, strange. All right, so here we are connecting the fan back into the motherboard like that. Like that. And like that. Okay. Okay. And where else? Right there. Okay. So let's connect this most important cable properly here. You want to take your time connecting this guy. All right. Okay, looks good. Like that. Okay, close this guy down. And
Yeah, okay.
So this is good, this is good. Everything is nice and clean. So we only have a battery to put in. Let's put the battery in. I'm not sure where's the connections for the battery are, right there. Okay. All right, so let's get all of the screws from here. Like that, so you can see the picture better. Okay. All right, the screw right here. Screw right there. Another one right here. And that's it. Well, I honestly don't see where else would I put maybe one right here. Well, maybe not. Let's put this guy in here. Yeah. Okay. Now let's connect the rest of the guys here. Easier said than done. You kind of have to rotate this guy a little bit here. Same for this connection, wasn't the simplest, but it's okay, it's all doable. Yeah. Come on. Okay, like that. Close this guy down. Next one. Come on. I guess I need to doesn't wanna about like that maybe. Oh, come on. Open up here. Open up right there. No, why is it at an angle? Oh, it's at an angle because the cable itself is at an angle. All right, let's see. Let me get this guy installed right here. All right, the rest of it is going to be probably connected like that. You wouldn't be able to see much in here. Okay. Come on. Come on. One more cable. I mean, I can't. I mean, I know I can, but it just. The video is probably going to be extremely long. Come on. So the hardest part in this repair is connecting all those cables like that, so everything is nice and straight. You just want to close this guy down like that. Let me bring the screws. Well, the casing shut down perfectly fine. All right. So once the laptop is screwed in together, right here, shorter screw goes right here. All of the longer screws go all over the perimeter. Connected in aftermarket power supply here from Dell. All right. And we show that it's charging right there. You see? The icon shows that it's charging. All right. And we got an orange light right here indicating that it's charging as well. All right, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe. Please leave a like. The reason you want to subscribe is, again, once I get chance, I will make a video saying which laptops I would buy for myself and which ones I wouldn't want to buy. I wouldn't spend my money on. All right. Thanks so much. Have a good day.